Greetings to Lotus, welcome back to the other school's Daggerfall. Right now we are in front of Scourg Barrow, or is it Scourg Barrow? I don't know how you pronounce that name. But yeah, we're here because... What's his name? What's his name? I think it's supposed to be... King of Rooms? Yes. He summoned us like a few months ago, no? I think he summoned us sometime last year to come to his demesne when it was convenient for me. And he had some of the other assignments for me, and the quest that he's about to give me is the soul of the Lich. Not real pity that we can't exactly carry the zombie around with us, but I'm gonna interrupt this just to show you this image and narrate what exactly the message was. And the message was something as follows. Stitched into the zombie's decaying flesh, you see the following message. Grimfangs, it would be an honor to have you visit me in my demesne at your convenience. I have a small matter that you are ideally suited for. In hindsight, it's no small matter at all. As always, my servants will test your mettle. Feel free to dispense with them. They can always be raised again. The King of Rooms, Master of Scourg Barrow. With that, we head back to the video now. Thank you for your patience.
I'm supposed to be raiding Sentinel, and it's going to be rough for me, especially because I have already made enemies of them, but at any rate, let's go ahead and see what this guy has to say. I mean, we're gonna make our way to him first, which is sort of hassle in itself. I think it's this one. I mean, this one also opens up all the previous as to what this one does, but I think it is this one. I jumped into either. Okay, hurt myself on the way down, but no issues. There are of course two zombies in here. Looks like they haven't discovered me yet. I think this is the way, but I'm not for sure. I could be wrong. Ah, it keeps us. Like, I would do anything if anything's not, get an encounter right now. I'm not sure whether I have to go down. I think the V probably is up the right way to go, that is. Did this have anything? Just a hidden door. Let's check it out. It's a zombie. Not somebody that I was eager to face right now, but oh well, I'll have it. I'll take it. I think I may have made a wrong turn. Oh no, the V was down. Yeah, we had to go down here. And this is his demesne. The King of Rooms demesne thing. We really need to bash it open. Yeah, thank you. Ah. Oh, great King of Rooms. And the dancers in front of you frivolously dancing like that. I wonder who that is. Ah, Scots. This guy looks badass, I'm not gonna lie. Nah. At any rate, ooh, look at that guy in the back here. That's literally undead, that guy. This one also looks really badass, this woman here. More troops for reanimation, I suppose. Anyway, let's go ahead and talk to... I wanna know what it says. You see the King of Clones? Alright, King of Clones. Let's see what you have for me. Grimfangs, I'm so glad you answered my letter. I hope my messenger was gentle. Not exactly, but I can understand your perspective. You have been a loyal servant in the past, not as loyal as my living dead, but far more versatile. My need involves the lowest depths of Castle Sentinel, and the reward is knowledge that only the dead can provide. Are you willing? I most certainly am. How amusing. I'm looking for the answer to a question. It doesn't exist among the living, but may exist among the dead. I want you to bring me back the coast of Prince Karolis, the great-grandfather of the late King Camelon of Sentinel. Karolis was a sorcerer of no mean skill. He is now a lich deep in the bowels of the castle. Prince Karolis, the great grandfather of King Cameron. So this is basically something that is directly connected to the main quest, and I suppose that is why we are covering this quest. I'm giving you a special scarab. If it is close to him, when you destroy his physical body, his soul will be trapped in the scarab. Bring it back to me and I will tell you a tale of a few mortals I've heard. Roger, roger. Hi there. I didn't expect you to be facing me while dancing. Why are you dancing so fast while she's dancing so slow? I wonder if these guys are also undead. I can hardly see her face, even though I can see, make out her face a little. But oh well. Let me just pause right here for a second. Anyway, let's pull our sword out and let's go. We'll go back the same way which we took to came here, which we took to come here. We climb up until we reach this place and then we... Oh wait, I made a wrong turn there. Went too far up. Yeah, we should have gone down from here onwards. I can use skeletons. Now, I am running right here and I really do not want to face these zombies, to be honest. Good thing they don't know how to jump. And we now have to climb our way out of here. Did I get stuck in a wall there? I hope not. Okay, this way. Right. Why am I getting stuck? Oh god. Am I gonna have to use a potion of levitation to get out this here? Ah, finally, we begin to climb. Alright then, time to get out. No, not really. It's already evening right now. And it's night. Damn, I spent a long time in there, didn't I? Even though it was morning when I first came there. Alright, time to head to Sentinel now. The issue is... I have... more or less spoiled the quest for myself. The main quest there, at least. And... I'm expecting trouble here. I mean, even from local guards. Backstab is improved. I don't see anybody trying to harass me right now. But I'm pretty sure that could change in a hurry. Because, let me tell you something. Let me just like show you guys something. Oh, wait. Wait, what? This one, maybe. Sen? Just... Is there nothing... Last time I came here, it warned us against, you know, essentially being from the Knights of the Rose and how they would execute anybody who was a member of the Knights of the Rose. But anyway, yeah, this here, Castle Sentinel, right here. And so I essentially, let's spoil the customers back when I was, oh, by the way, I installed the Red Guard mod, which makes the skins, the Red Guards and the, you know, Dunmer skins the appropriate color. They're no longer whitewashed. I see no guards attacking me thus far, but yeah, anyway, back to what I was saying. I have more or less spoiled this quest for myself, and look at that emerge out of the distance like that. It looks imposing, doesn't it? Anyway, what I was saying is, what I know about this quest is that I don't know where exactly I have to go, but what I do know is that let me explain the save first. That Lich is supposed to be somewhere behind locked doors. And like a magic invel door. Well, these guys aren't attacking me yet, so I assume I'm alright. Yeah, thus far. Right up until I actually get into where I'm supposed to go. What is that thing on your head? I think I saw you before, but oh well. Anyway, this is not where we have to go. We have to go straight. And this is like one of the fewer dungeons, a fewer. By the way, places that you are allowed to explore, like the one of the fewer castles. And I suppose that's because it is so large. It's the first time I've seen glass in this game. It looks pretty. Yeah, so Lich is supposed to be behind a magically locked door. The problem is, this magically locked door requires like a sequence of levers to open. And I don't remember if they were supposed to be activated in a certain sequence or whether they were all just supposed to be activated. And yeah. So the thing is, I don't know where these levers are. And it's gonna be rough, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna be aiming to use my shirt of undeniable access to try and open this door. I'm not gonna be talking to the Queen because, yeah, I don't want to tell her that I'm actually here for somebody she cares about. Maybe she does not care about them, but yeah, I still do not want to tell her why I'm here. No, just the armor. So yeah, this is pretty much what I like about Castle Sentinel, that the fact that you can literally roam about as you want, where you want. And yeah, this is the entrance to the dungeon. I would not have known this stuff had I not, you know, mistakenly explored Castle Sentinel before. I mean, you're free to go everywhere. There are no guards that will stop you from going anywhere. Except for once you set foot inside the actual dungeon itself. And even then, it is only the guards of the dungeon that, you know, essentially oppose you, and nobody else. And as you can see, the music is still that of the soothing music of being inside a castle thus far. I think it's gonna change soon, but I'm not sure. So yeah, sure to undeniable access it is. Once we get to the locker. Hopefully that will open it, but if it does not open the door, yeah, now turn into dungeon music. Once the dungeon rendered in. But if it does not open the door, then we'll have to figure out what else to do. I see a rope here. It's a warrior, not a rogue. Ebony broadsword, I could sell that for some money. Decent gold. Let me take the gold as well. 732 pieces. Danger Brad Baldron. Is mine used at all? It's new plus 10 to AR. My god. I just wish somebody would have like a Daedric left hold on, or some Daedric boots, or some Daedric, you know, gloves, or some Daedric helms. Now, the exit to the dungeon is significantly far off, so I'm just gonna keep this stuff in my inventory instead of going all the way back. Yeah, let's go straight inside. A very convoluted mess, this dungeon. Why did I hear skeletons? Is the question that I would like answered. Let's go this way. An extremely complex series of mazes. Nothing here, I'll just pick this back off, because off the ground I mean, because yeah, I needed to mark everywhere I'm going in this dungeon in particular, like Castle Sentinel. The dungeon section is very complicated. Okay, some loot on the ground there. Some more stuff we can use to mark our advance along the way. I can see like a whoa. She scared me. I think it's a... it's an effect of the music in combination with her appearing suddenly in front of me like that. Oh, by the way, I also changed up the shield. I got a darker one. It seems to suit better with the rest of my equipment right now because they're all darkish. And I also got like a... what do you call this? A Daedric Katana. I found it in the last shop and I decided to use it. Nothing here. Shall we try going this way then? Alright. Since we're going this way, let me drop something else here. Let me lift Boston quite a few times. It is a knight. Ooh, this one had a Daedric Saber. Here, my katana is stronger. Although I could probably sell it for like a significant chunk of gold, so I'll keep it with me. Oh wait, one more sec. Let me just check if this is not being shaded out. Alright, this way then. But which way do we want to go first? There's also this way up there. This is like a huge mess, this entire dungeon. Like, I'm having to drop so many things on the ground just to, you know, demarcate where I've been and where I'm going. Okay, this way. I mean, I don't think we need to do that since there's like only one way right here. Some more loot for us. I wonder what we would have done if we had essentially stumbled upon the ledge when we were doing the Prince looting quest. I think this calls for a save. I can hear a skeleton. Which is sort of strange because I did not expect there would be skeletons in this dungeon. But then again, if there are liches here, then skeletons are probably not that far behind, to be honest. Now at this point I've got no idea where I'm going. I mean, that's just how complex this dungeon is. Some blood and what seems to be instruments of torture. Oh well. It seems that the dungeon just does not stop going deeper and deeper. Okay, I see a log. I feel like this is going to be a pretty long dungeon raid. Oh, hi there. I have no idea what you're guarding except for some dead people. Elven Daikatana. I mean, and an eye as well. These people have some really, really good loot. Dwarven shortbow, mithril shortbow, I think. Yeah, the mithril one has like better utility, so I'll just take the mithril one. I'll keep that in my inventory, and let's take a look at this helm. Plus 3, I think it's plus 5. Yes, it is. So I've basically got a mithril helm right now, or an elven helm. I think it's an elven helm. The helm of the elves. Nothing here. Finally reach a dead end. Like, in dungeons like these, I'm sort of happy to reach dead ends because that signifies that I have at least covered a part of it. Otherwise it just seems gigantic at Labyrinthian. I mean. Let me check this side out. I think Mithril should let me... okay, that is where we came from. Right. Let me pick that back up, and I'll drop it on this side then. More choices. But I think it's just like a room with nothing in it. That was the knight, we faded off. She did some damage, I did some damage. Here's what I don't understand. How is it that she's a knight but she has leather pauldrons and vamp braces? And two of them. I mean, knights are not supposed to have that. Knights are not supposed to be able to wear such low tier armor. A false knight, perhaps. Someone knighted by Sentinel but not actually a knight, maybe. Hi there. I see you did not notice me. It was not a backstab, but more like a sidestab. And a warrior. The same as me. Both steel. Still looks different because of the design of the weapon. Well, not that steel looks different, I said it still looks different. Then same again. Now where do we go? Alright, this way, let's go this way. Let us try covering this way first. Somebody opened the door, signifying that there's a wraith in here? Huh. I mean, if there is like a lich in there, then there's most definitely going to be wraiths as well. Good thing I bought a potion of heal too in that instance. In such an instance, I mean. Oh no, it's a poor woman being tortured. Warriors tend to have like far more health as compared to this looks amazing. Elven critters. I don't think I ever have this. I think I created directly to Dwarven. Now look at this. Ebony critters is 6.25 kilograms, but this is 12.5 kilograms. That is impressive, to say the least. Plus one health. Yeah, nothing else of interest here. Wish I could save you last, but unfortunately the developers did not want me to be able to. Oh, hi there. Let's fight through the store in between us. And let me wreck you, nonetheless. I wonder if that counts as water cover. Iron Warhammer. Elven Daikatana. Oh, typically Elven stuff. Now, this gives me hope because I was... For my mage playthrough, I was looking to go for a character with a staff, and these guys have staffs that go up in tier, then yeah, that does bring me hope. Elven Daikatana. Typically, I would have taken this stuff, like Elven Daikatanas and stuff, things of that nature, but yeah, this guy, he's unfortunately already dead, nothing can be done about him. Or her, I don't know what it was at this point. It's barely recognizable. Okay, let's try Green Street. And warrior dead. It's like I'm only finding elven tier loot in this dungeon, and I'm gonna assume this elven pauldron. Too bad I already have a dwarven pauldron. It's strange. What confuses me is the fact that they like to call it elven, like the wraith tier setup, it's elven, then there's dwarven, and then there's mithril. Now, here's the problem. Mithril is not a material that is native to this game. To the Elder Scrolls, there's no mithril in the lore of the Elder Scrolls. It is something borrowed from Tolkien's works, and mithril is actually a weight that we came the wrong way. Let me pick that back up. The blood that I dropped. I took a left here. Okay, let's take a right then. So there's mithril in the lore of the Elder Scrolls. There is let's cover this section first. Somebody who can go for us, how polite of you. Yeah, so Mithril comes from Lord of the Rings, or rather the world of Middle-earth, and it is essentially supposed to mean elven, of elven build. It's like a form of silver and steel which the elvens craft, which is supposed to be, while ultra light, also ultra durable. It's supposed to be like the strongest material in the world of Middle-earth, essentially. Now, here's what confuses me, is that they have got it set up such as elven is like if you take elven, dwarven, or rather dwemer, to be more accurate to the lore of the Elder Scrolls, elven is lower than dwarven or dwemer, and then there's mithril, which is higher than dwarven or dwemer. But the problem is both of them are essentially the same thing. Elven and mithril are supposed to be the same thing, and it just confuses the hell out of me, because I think that, okay, maybe it's, you know, elven. Whenever I hear mithril, I just hear elven. So yeah, it always confuses me. It's a wraith. I hope that's all it is. Yep, it's just a wraith. No need to put this down here. Some of the enemy sounds in this game just chill you to the bone as well. The wraiths and skeletons and whatnot. The skeletons especially are horrible. Oh, hi there. You look like a rogue. Yeah, was about to say that. Ooh, what are these? Of course, we can move the bar of whatever that is. 108 gold pieces. A helm plus 3 drum rating. Not a bad helm. I would have liked to have that. It's strange how rogues can hit you so easily. And so hard at that, because other creatures, like even warriors, were not hitting that hard. Rogues, though, they hit super hard. Alright, so now that we've covered this side here, let's rest among the living dead. Or rather, the dead dead. Because these dead aren't living. Alright then. Stealth and long lane has improved, which is quite heartwarming to know. I'd always wanted to improve my stealth and my long lane. Now, I'm not gonna go into that section over there, to the right, the open door to the right. I will close it back up again. This looks like... That looks like an elevator of sorts. Does touching the torch do anything? No? Strange, because it does look like an elevator. Maybe it's just the fact that the tile is very conveniently placed in the corner over there. That makes it look like so, but yeah. So I'm just gonna close this door because I do not intend to go up it yet. Oh wait, there is that door here. What I'm gonna do before this is check out this side. This side is where I believe we haven't gone yet. Well, this side takes me up as well, and so does this, but I'll just follow this these stairs. Why is this? Oh shit, I did not see this, guys. I did not see these guys at all. Two warriors coming out nowhere, my god. Reminds me of myself. With how sometimes I can't see. Like, my enemies can't see. Let's refit that thing. Okay. Of course, I can't carry that. What about your helm, though? It's, no use. It's a pretty damn useless helm. Where did that come from? There seems to be the way that we came in from, and then there is this door here, which we don't really know where it leads. Did this path go anywhere, I wonder? Was it the end of that path? I want to check this door, check this path out first before I go to that road. It's nothing from the looks of it. Another warrior. The last time I came here, maybe it was because I was in a different section, but I was mostly facing off against rogues. This time around, however, I'm facing mostly warriors. Now to get up, go up the steps here. Excuse me. Just made confirming to make sure there's nothing else here. There's a way up. We have no idea where this goes. But I do see a rogue, so let me just go ahead and take care of him first. Well, this guy looks like a rogue. I'm not certain if this guy is a rogue or not. She's definitely a rogue. Okay, I suppose I have reached the limit for my... That looks like a cool helm, but it only gives plus 3 to armor rating. I got excited, but maybe... Just maybe it is an epic helm, which it is not. It's not an epic helm. Let me just go and check the helm nonetheless, even though it looks quite basic. Plus 1, of course. Just some random skulls on a pike. Trough to feed pigs, from the looks of it. Is there a bugbear there? That's a stake. Is that a hidden door? I feel like it is. Who hit me? Really? There was a grave there. I could not even see the damn thing. Steel stuff. Okay. It is magical, so that tempts me to actually try and take it. But I can't, so what can I drop from my belongings, I wonder? Now this scarab is important, can't exactly drop that. Is there anything heavy that I'm carrying? 1.5 kilograms, 1.5 kilograms. How heavy is this? 2.5 kilograms, right? 1.25 kilograms. Yeah, let's drop that, and if we remove like two of these, we should have enough space for this. I guess the game wants us to keep dropping more stuff. This should probably not be as heavy. No, it is not. 0.25 kilograms, 0.25, 0.25. Sometimes the wraiths can have like stuff for you. Sometimes, not always. There are of course enemies nearby. I do hope that I don't die, so I'm gonna make a save in the emergency slot here. I wonder where these enemies are because I can't see them. Do they have reached the dead end here? Hopefully, nope, I still can't rest here because there are apparently enemies nearby. I cannot even see the street. Where was this guy? Yeah, no way to those here. Came from there. Let us mark this place with some blood. Anything here? No, nothing here. Let us mark this place with some blood as well. The blood of the scribe. That is the name of a song by Lapapot. If you've heard of the band, good on you. Okay, Carolaria Buckingston suddenly runs away, her feet making no sound as she disappears into the shadows. Okay, I did not realize I had some quests going on. I don't think I ever had like an escort quest like this. I wonder what's going on. Carolaria Buckingston suddenly runs away, her feet making no sound as she disappears, as she disappears into the shadows. I'm healed. Huh. Maybe that means that there are going to be no more assassins coming after me. Either. I see a hidden door behind you. Oh, the hidden door was just a door. One of the things that I noticed was about this dungeon is that there are no hidden doors. There are literally no hidden doors in this dungeon. Thus far at least. Don't want to jinx it. It's crazy that the move that's supposed to essentially guarantee you a hit is the one that got blocked in this instance. Like thrusting your fist like this, that's supposed to be like a sure shot hit. And it does like minimal damage. But it got blocked. Let's try going this side first. I see an enemy, let me take care of you first before I go ahead and let him open that door there. Yeah. The thrust attack, least amount of damage, greatest chance of it. Cannot carry any more. I'm just checking for some, you know, worthwhile loot. Even though I know I can't carry any more stuff. There's nothing here, maybe except for a rest spot that we can use, should be required. Speaking of this, go ahead and rest. Critical strike is improved. I don't even recall which way I came from anymore. Ah, by the way, we haven't gone this way and this way. Right. The way we are heading right now, we haven't gone there yet. Now, I'm changing levels, so I'm considering maybe going back and going to the proper, you know, basic and adamantium warhammer, literal longbow. Now this is something that I feel like I could make good use of, so I'm gonna take that. Well, there's practically no difference between longbows and shortbows, so it doesn't make sense to take, you know, take one and leave the other. Pretty bad. I just wish I could conflict that out. Now, should I? Let's just go and explore the other side first. We'll come back here later. If I remember to that is, because this dungeon module already has me confused. We haven't gone this way. Let us go this way. There's no difference between longbows and shortbows apart from the fact that one of them is easier to use. No, not easier to use. One of them does more damage. So, can't carry any more stuff, of course. Still trying nonetheless. Plus one rating armor helm. Plus one. A helm with a plus one rating. Ooh, goddammit. Plus one rating helm. Doesn't hurt to try, does it? Oh, hi there. I almost did not see you. The stepping strategy actually seems to work wonders. Even though it is more of a hack. 240 gold pieces, can I take them? Of course not. I'll stop trying to take gold. But too bad we can't exactly interact with these shelves, because otherwise it would have been at least a free weaponry for us, you know? Oh, so I've already been here before. So this is one of the places where I've already been before. Ah, alright. Except for this direction here. We'll come back to this place then, in that case. Let's go upstairs instead. The problem with dungeons that are as large as this is the fact that thought there was somebody. Looks like a warrior, based on the helmet. And he's dead in the middle of a door. Of this door right here. Yeah, I can't take the cool soldiers that we beat, but this still the same. No difference. Oh, damn. Oh, okay. I'm assuming there's nothing here except for a dead end. Wonder why they even made all these, you know, passages if all they were supposed to be were dead ends. We are going even further up this time around. Okay, now it diverges. I have a feeling that it's gonna meet up ahead. No, it does not. Never mind then. The room with the dead guy in the cage. Why did I even bother? Yeah, why did I even bother with even this British army? I've got ebony prayers for crying out loud. The only thing that I should be trying to get right now is a red Pyrrhus, which indicates it's a red one or a green one. I mean, Dwarven Pyrrhus is also nice. The Dwarven Pyrrhus would also be quite nice, actually. Did anybody open? Somebody opened this door? How can they hear the footsteps and tell that they are not? Potion still falling? Yeah, I don't really think that. I mean, I'm not an enchanter, I'm a thing. The rule of an enchanter, just look at this. Just look how pretty it looks. Now, here's the thing. The ebony Pyrrhus is pretty much, ebony tier items are pretty much considered the best tier items in the game because they not only give you a really good amount of additional armor rating, but they're also pretty light. Taking the contrast, my Dwarven Greaves, they give me plus 10 to armor bonus, but they be 3 kilograms. This too, plus 10, but 2.5 kilograms, considering the fact that they are Greaves. In contrast, look at this. Plus 6, but 1.5 kilograms. So, yeah, they the higher tier armor you take, I mean, they do provide bonuses in the form of better armor class, but at the same time, they also... What the hell? Where did you come from? Come here, let me kill you. Yeah, do you have anything for me? No, of course not. But they're also heavy, essentially. Rogue died in 3 hits, that was must have been 3 solid hits there. Plus 1 to armor rating. And this edge also has nothing, no hidden doors either. Right, no hidden doors. So I'm glad to know and understand that I'm finally getting to clear this entire area, this entire dungeon, so to speak. Now what I want to do is I'm going to go back to that place that I abandoned and resume searching in the other direction. But there are still places with stairs and stuff that I have not taken yet. And those areas are something that do still interest me. The issue is just making the mental route of those places because as it stands, we can't exactly... make notes on this map here. This side goes down, let us try going down and seeing what's up. I think this might lead us to somewhere we have already been. But even if it doesn't, it's fine. No treasure? Yeah, no treasure. sometimes these guys are treasures, and when they do, it's usually like a, yeah, we have a computer, we look this way, but we forgot to look this way. Apparently there's a way here as well. This has happened to me once in a similar dungeon before. I discovered an entirely new place by doing just that. And that is why it's essential to like retracing steps, even if it seems tedious in Daggerfall. My god, this guy hits hard. 72 rupees, a poor rogue at that. But certainly it's hard. Hi there! Time for me to slaughter you. 132 rupees. Now, I wonder what happened that I can suddenly start picking up gold again. And before I go there, I just want to quickly check out this side. I feel like it's going to be dead end as well, but yeah, you never know. Seems to be some place where I can go up. I'll come back to you. Let me go explore this other side first. Let us stop running and start treading wisely. Without haste. Who is this ugly guy? Looks like an orc of some sort. Like, will this tell me if I click on it in interaction mode? No? Even seems to be like a whole throne room. Interesting. Reminds me of some sort of undercame. Okay, it's like an entire convoluted maze, right? Oh, hi there! We have a drawn battle axe. I used to own that one, one of those. Pretty reliable weapon, if you ask me. For a while, it was my only defense against harpies and other creatures. It's big! It's a baby piggy! Hi there! I don't know why that these things look so large. I suppose these are supposed to be part of some kind of quest. Let me check out this room. These boxes were meant to be lootable. Log is looking here for me. Yeah, I showed that log, didn't I? Nothing to fear from me. As if. Reminds me of Doom and that saying, all the fear is you. Yeah, sounds pretty badass to me actually. This goes down, let us trudge onwards for a change. We've already been here before. Yes, we have. We have already been here before. Okay, alright, I'll just pick this back up. And so, see, this is the advantage of dropping stuff on the ground. It lets you know where you have been and haven't been. It makes life easy for you. Yeah, we haven't been to the easy areas before. Okay, we're going further down. Alright. That is a random skull. Probably should have seen before I tried touching it again. Probably should have saved before I tried touching it twice. Clear. Let us fart operator. I hear a door opening. I don't know whether that's behind me or in front of me. But if I'm suddenly unable to back up, it's probably, yeah, the door behind me. Ooh, a dwarven flail. Look at this guy. If he had landed it on me, he would have scored big time. Too bad I'm too fast for him. Why did this door open? Strange. Nothing on this side from the looks of it. Yeah, nothing here. Even there? Like, no. Alright. Yeah, no hidden doors there. I wonder why that door opened up. And hey, look at that, from the looks of it. I have magical ability. I wonder how that happened. I mean, look at it. I've got like an entire magical page right now. Which is full. Even though I can't cast any spells. So, we apparently have come here before. I wonder how that happened. Okay. Did we explore down there to the left, I mean? I think we may not have done that. Yeah, we did not go the other way. We came down from here. And now let me drop something here. I for some reason thought that the stairs that we used to come down was all the way over there. Like, in this section there. Rogue. These guys hit hard. I don't know why. Also have a very good success rate when it comes to hitting you. Helm. Plus 1 to AR. Nothing here. Good that we cleared that off the map. Right then, so let us keep crushing onwards. Sometimes these banners have things hidden behind them. Usually when it's the case, there's like a hidden, you know, compartment in the back. So you can always tell that there is something hidden there. This is not something that we've dropped, this is like a pile of loot that is readily on the ground. Maybe we can restock. Supplies. A cauldron there, for whatever reason. As soon as I open the door, I suppose you were trapped in there, and that is the gratitude that I get. Trapped with nothing but your loot. And the gratitude that I get for opening the door for you is violence. It makes you reconsider a lot of things, doesn't it? But from whatever we have explored thus far, it is quite evident that we are miles away from where we are supposed to be. With that being said, what are the rest of the places that we're supposed to explore over here? Over there elsewhere. I mean, I'm already turned around as it is. I don't know where to go anymore. Here right now. Okay, so basically what we want to do is go upstairs, and then there are like a few areas here that we have not checked out yet, the specific area. Oh no, we have, it's just a set of stairs that takes us under. Have we checked this area out? No, we have not. So maybe we go back upstairs and check out this side, because we have not gone there yet. Eventually we're supposed to, we're about to stumble somewhere, right? Hi there, Wait. Too bad I killed you before you get a hit off. Yeah, this is like the area where which we haven't explored yet, so let's go ahead and explore the side. The problem that I'm now facing is the fact that I don't know how to get back to the very beginning of the dungeon. So probably gonna have to keep running around until I do find the exit. Usually this place has like an enemy over here on this on undead corner, or to the other corner. But the corner that you can't see, they typically leap out to ambush you, but I suppose there was no such enemy this time around. Now that we have covered this piece as well, where do you want to go now? I think we have already been there. We have another set of stairs. I think we took like two set of stairs to come here. There is like another area that is left unexplored here. Two areas, rather. Right then, let's take the stairs. Let's go up and take the stairs. I can completely turn around at this spot. That is where we came from, if I'm not wrong. Yeah, we have not been this way, so let me just drop something here and try going there. This area is super complex. I can see something burning there. The campfire. I guess we have been there. Because of that, no. That's something we kept here. So this is again another way that we have not been, so let us go ahead and check this side out. Although we have been here. Yeah, it ends nothing except for this tiny little room. Alright then. So this is the problem with the dungeons in Daggerfall. It's that we have not been here yet, so let's try and explore this side. If you aren't mindful of where you're going, if you don't clear out the same level that you essentially were in the first time around, before you change levels in this game, you're going to be confused about where you're going. Even with that, you can be like super confused. Because of all the entries and exits that this game has to offer. Hi there. Let's have a fight. I'm only spamming like single attack, but this one is unable to keep up with me. Adamantium, I think I've got one better. I've got Ebony. Unless it's the other way around. Too bad I don't have the axe on me right now to check. But let's try this thing here. I think I can. Yes. Even though I heard just heard a creature growl, apparently I can miss you. Right now I'm trying to search for the place that I'd been in. No luck regarding that whatsoever. But this game already been here. Yeah, we have already been here. Right, so this is just an alternative way to go elsewhere. No, if I recall correctly. Right. I wonder why I even stopped coming here. Now, where do we go? Is the question. And I wonder if the skill, the magical skill, oh wait, this, I think there's one more place here that we have not yet explored. Let's go there and finish exploring that then. Is it this left? Yeah, this left, there's no left. And to the left again. Right. Not right, left. A way up and a way that is not up, let us take a way that is not up. Hi there, warrior. Well met. Let us see who has the better sword. Which would clearly be me at this point. 408 gold pieces, my god. I time to head upstairs, I suppose. Now, there are two parts here. I'm gonna check out this side first. I will come to that side later. Some sort of heraldry there. And that looks like another warrior. Unless it's a knight. I think it's a knight rather than a warrior. Oh, it's a warrior. Mithril broadsword. Impressive. Steel greaves, 3 kilograms. Digit greaves, 3 kilograms. 264 gold pieces. And a rather decent helm, but not one that I'm searching for. Okay, time to head over this way, I suppose. I don't know if I've been underneath this area. Looks like I have not. Maybe exploring that might be... Oh no, we have already been down there. Yeah, better not have fallen. If you run fast enough, you don't even need to jump over that gap there. A dead end room, from the looks of it. Oh no. Not at all a dead end room. But a warrior there. With Spartan helm. No wonder he was so brave. The steam portals look amazing. Ah, some more loot. And this would be a steel longbow. Nothing of value for me. Like, it's not of value to me. Let's see if this piece has something. Just some more loot. It makes me thankful, but then it also makes me really disappointed in realizing that I now need to find out where else I can go. Like, retrace my steps essentially, which is something of a very difficult thing with a dungeon of this size. So this is where I came from, and I would assume that is where I came from. I can only assume. We haven't been to the right yet, so let us try going to the right. I think this was one of the places that we visited before, but we decided not to check out. Because it was considered, like, it concerned changing levels. But when there are like D-junctions like this and this, a door on the other side, I like to open through and check whether it has anything more to it. How many days do I have for this quest? None. I mean, the game was just pretty generous from the looks of it. I mean, he did not give me any time limit to even respond to him, come over to his, demesne, as he put it. And neither did he give me any time limit to complete this quest. He's pretty generous, pretty generous. He's in no hurry. But I suppose when you're immortal, time and the concurrent time limits are essentially meaningless to you. Sometimes they have loot. And sometimes, the loot that they have sometimes is worthwhile. Other times, not so much. That's a mithril claymore. Cannot carry more stuff. I'm yet to come across any evils. That sort of concerns me. Tells me that I've been exploring the completely wrong part of the dungeon thus far. Now that we have explored the other side, which way do we go next? Let me just drop something here so that I know that I've come here before. Have you been the other way? Yeah, we have. It was one of those places that never really led to anything much. Okay. Seems we have not been that away, because there's no wall blocking off the place. So I think what we can do next is go and check out that side. Which way were you supposed to turn again? Of course it was right. And this way, yeah, we have not been straight with these guys. With these here guys. Just to mark that as completed. But before I go there, I would like to clear out this room, whatever it is. Thankfully, it's just a resting spot. Not that I need a rest right now. I stand by that statement even after having defeated this warrior. Typically, they do teeter up my health a little bit. But in this case, they did not. So that's good. I hear some things flapping. Crossroads here. Let me guess. It doesn't matter which way you take. And turns out if you hover around long enough, you are going to come across. I literally walked into that one. I did. And did we? Yes, we did. Let me take these boots off so that I can wear these ones instead. No, I wanna equip them. Thank you very much. Plus 7 to armor rating, plus 8. Yeah, ebony is indeed better. Then adamantium, 144 gold pieces. 9 million gross. Ebony and adamantium are also lighter. Than mithril and other things. I just wish I could carry this with me, but yeah, no can do. No can be saver. I don't know if it even means something, I just said something. Did I just make an entire loop? Yes, I did. Yes, indeed I did. I wonder what's there on the other side. But... just some loot. I dropped some loot to pick up some loot. Right then. Two parts here, I see a door in front of me, and I see what seems to be something else in front of me. And we're going down. Maybe I should go back up and clear out the door first, because it's on the same level. I don't know who opened this door, because that guy was looking. The knight had his back to me. Probably should have called out to him before I slaughtered him like that, but oh well. It's best that lambs don't realize when they're being slaughtered. Alright, time to drop this back here again. Thus far, I haven't had to use any of the magical stuff that I carry around with me. It makes me sort of sad. Not too sad, just a little bit. But, yeah. But I'm also thankful that I've never had to come across a situation where I've absolutely had to use them. I don't think I've ever been here before. Those are huge pieces. Ah, so we have been here before. Let's go back up there. I guess this was another one of those areas where I decided not to go check because it was changing levels. And I just decided to check some pieces instead. A lovely room full of coffins. Anything there? Nope, not really. Some of these doors look like hidden doors, but I think they're not. Let's check this side. Dropped a pomegranate just to demarcate the fact that I am indeed checking this side. Why did I unequip that? Accidentally clicked on it. Wait, what? It's not a magical item, right? Holding a miscellaneous, did I? Where did my shield go? Oh, come on. Lots of letters of credit and potions. Much like a shield back, thank you. Left hand equipped what exactly? Yeah, let's re-equip them again. Where did my shield go? Oh no. It just disappeared. Well, I looked like it played back on me, but it's not of any urgency, to be honest. It just looks cool, but I'm still looking for my shield. Where's my shield? It's like it just disappeared all of a sudden. Did it suddenly get into the ingredients list? There's the shield here. Strange. Very strange if you ask me. Am I like left without a shield now? That sucks. Well, I suppose I could just do this then. Doing this is nothing special, it just makes it easier to, well, essentially, have you been here before? Seems to be the case, yes, we have been here before. Just one of the branches that we have not previously explored. I think we have explored this side as well before. So now the question remains, how do we get out of here? Wait, there's something over here that we have not checked out yet. Yeah, I do not see a wall there, so maybe we can go in and check that side out. I'm just gonna get poked in because I've gotten here to go already. Hmm. that's not the way to go. We follow this way. We have actually checked out that side. Yeah, that's what is wrong. I mean, I was pretty sure that we checked out all the sides here. And I think that is where we came from. But I think we did not check downstairs completely, so like we decided to come back up instead. So it would seem that we have checked everything downstairs too. I guess we go back up then. And if we see another one of those dead bodies, I'll be sure to check them for a shield. And the stairs are this way. Maybe there's a guard in there, right? Like a warrior. Maybe this guy has a shield. Yes, he does. Yes, he does. I want to unequip this and equip this, but for that I need to drop some first. How heavy is this? 4.5 kilograms, 6.25, my god. I don't know why that sheep just disappeared from my inventory like that. Pretty rude of the shield, if you ask me. Yeah, the round shield, not really interested in that. What do I drop? This question. Letter of credit, which is 9,680 gold pieces. So, in case you guys don't know, I'm like a millionaire right now. I could drop all these arrows, 7.5 kilogram. I could equip the shield here. Really? But I just emptied these arrows from my inventory. What are you talking about? What else? 2.5 kilograms? 0.25 kilograms? Feather weight? 5.5 kilograms? Oblivion? This is like a god tier weapon. A god tier weapon, so I'm not gonna drop that. Let's drop a whole bunch of potions and stuff until we can like equip this. Really, my god. Can I equip this now? No? I mean, you're really gonna make me... Thank you. My god. Let's try and take some of this back now. The 30 arrows that I had, unfortunately, they're gonna be... Yeah. That is sad indeed. But, oh well. It is as things go. I somehow lost my shield, just like that. Good thing I found a new one, but I somehow lost my shield. And I do believe this is the way for us to go. The point is to try and find a way back up. Oh, I think there's this section right here that we have not checked out yet. So I do believe, no, that is where we came down from. But I think there was something up there that we haven't checked out, we had not checked out yet. Like some part of the map that we had not visited. No, that's also walled off. You know what, let's just go back up and figure it out once we're there. It doesn't make sense to stay here and try and do it. Yeah, it doesn't really matter which way we take, we're always gonna... We're gonna find ourselves going this way anyway. Is there anything else that I wanted to explore with you? None, right? Hmm. Have we been this way before? Well, that is a valid question. It seems we have. We have been that way before, but we have not been this way before. That way is blocked off. That way is blocked off. The only way forward is here then. And it would seem we have been there. From the looks of it. From whatever I can gather, I mean. We have already been there. Where else have we not been? In this occlusive dungeon. This labyrinth of attention. I suppose the only place remaining is to go up, further up, as high as we can go, and try seeking where else we could go once we're there. I've moved up to a dead end. This room also ends in a dead end. So going up there isn't all that it's hyped up to be. Yeah, there isn't really a point to going up there as such. So the question now remains, where else should we go? This would be up here, which takes us somewhere over here. Takes us even further up. And through these complicated maze-like structures up to nowhere. We go nowhere following that route. Then there's also this section right here. Where does this take us? To yet another dead end. Does it really take us anywhere? Which beckons the question, how the hell did we get down here? On this side, yes, there are. I want to know where Castle Sentinel is, because we have also explored Castle Sentinel, right? I want to know where Castle Sentinel is. So this is essentially where the entrance is. That is Castle Sentinel. This is the elevator that we took to get to the entrance. And this is where we came down. Oh, so we have already been here as well. Okay, so we have covered these sections that we have previously been to. Huh. Interesting. Seems to be an elevator there. Maybe we could use that elevator? Seems like it would be worth a shot. How do we get there though? I think we need to go up a level as soon as I can find my own character, that is. Alright, so my character would be here. And we need to go all the way over there. Yeah, which is here. And it should lead us to some place with an elevator, I do believe. Yeah, we take that path down and further down, and we end up into a hallway with an elevator. So, further up, further up, further up. So first we go here, that's like the shorter path to get there. And the way to get there is, I think, to go straight and take a right. Straight and right, right? Yes, it is. Straight and right. Alright. And then I think we take a right yet again. And I think we're supposed to take the route which takes us down, so it would be this here. I had a feeling this was going to be a long dungeon crawl, and it actually is a long dungeon crawl. And I don't think we take a left here, we keep heading to our right. Because if we take a left, it just takes us into a whole different dungeon module. I did see an area with an elevator, I just forgot where it was, I was trying to search for it all this while. I couldn't find it. And I don't believe this is it, the area with the elevator. Yes, right here. Here it is. You're not supposed to jump down there so easily, you know? Hi there. Climb up, please. Can you... Oh my god. It's like climbing is easier from the corners than it is from the pieces. Than it is from street, from the streets. I risked them for 2 hours, but the elevator took its time coming down. Right then. I wonder where that took me. I think. Oh no, wait, let me just go to the game. Can sort of technically get off here, but I'm not going to risk it. What is this? Ooh, what is this? Ooh, bars, huh? Is this the room that we need to get to? Because this, if so, this is interesting. Can I just click my... Can I touch these bars? Apparently not. Long shirt of undeniable access. Nope, can't use that. Here. I decided to drop off here and see what else this dungeon module has to offer. Oh hey, I think I see one of the levers here. and I think that provides me access to... No, come back, Tom. Hi, are you done? Thank you. You know what, let's just follow it down, then we can reactivate it and come back up. So at least it opens this door here. I'm gonna save the game here. So I suppose this is what it was talking about when it said when it was telling us to unlock all these, you know, use all these levers to unlock stuff. Now, this lever here seems sort of iffy. I'm just gonna go ahead and save in the emergency slot. Oh, okay. It just gets us down. Like, takes us down. Nothing else. These areas is locked. So this is pretty much the place that I was searching for. And I suppose this is where the Lich is supposed to be. When we return, it's gonna be a hell of a fight. Finally, we make some progress. And I actually thought that the Castle Sentinel would be much larger. And even though it is convoluted, it isn't as large as I thought it would be. Like something like 18 or 20 or 24 modules, somewhere along those lines. From what I can see thus far. Unless this takes us to an entirely new dungeon module altogether. Eye out for exits that we can take. Can't see any thus far. Okay. Now this, something over there. I see a grave, all the way over there. Yeah, let me just take you out, and let me just go check out whatever's on this side. Oh, all right. So I think that is how you get across all of these areas with the levers. Okay, let's try throwing this lever here. I think that reactivates some of the other lever on the other side. Wish me luck here, because I don't know what I'm walking into, to be honest. Thought it might try doing that. That did something, I don't know what it did, but that did something. I can hear something crazy. I don't know what that is, but I hear something really crazy. Is the elevator coming down? Excuse me? No? Did it get locked or something? Let me unflip this. Hold on. Is the elevator coming down now? No? What's going on there? I want to check out what's going on. Let me just use a potion of levitation. Because I feel like the elevator is sort of stuck here. I can see like a spider here. Okay. Interesting. Don't know what's going on here, but... You know what? While we're at it, might as well just go ahead and... reactivate that switch. I don't know what it's gonna do, but let's try doing whatever it does. Like, let's try reactivating it. And yeah. Aha, plenty of potions of levitation, so I don't think that is going to pose any kind of problem. There are more ways for us to go up and down in this here dungeon. Stuck behind one of these doors right now. That's not a problem. We can just elevate our way up. We keep this switch, we flip that switch, and what else? This here, we come out on this here side. We have yet another place that we can go and check out. Let us go all the way down. I just hope that the elevator isn't blocking our path when we do finally get up there. Time to pop in a potion of levitation again. Since we have made such progress, let me just go ahead and save here. I don't think I've done that yet, but anyway. Good thing I bought a few potions of levitation when I did. Because this levitation essentially gave out on us. Not in a good way. This part is not locked, but at the same time it has no papers to proceed either. Let me try going down and checking if that path down there is now accessible, the other side, I mean. Not this here one. Now, I actually prefer the potion of levitation, like using the potion of levitation to slide down, because, no, it's still here. I mean, I wonder how we open this side up. I prefer the potion of levitation over the potion of slow falling, because it's actually faster. And you actually have control over your character by the levitate. You don't have that by the slow fall. Which I find is something that sucks, to be honest, but can't do too much about it. Oh no! We're trapped on this side as well. Now how do we get out? I think it has something to do with those rods that we put. I think that is where the sequence of pulling them comes in handy. Let's just pause here for a second though. WC break there, for those of you who are European. But yeah, process of elimination we're going to be following the process of elimination to see essentially which one of these levers needs to be deactivated. This is a long elevator right now. I think this deactivating like a lot of these these goods here. Let's see if that opens us up. Nope, that still has me trapped. I wonder if that's the sound of my own character falling repeatedly onto the elevator. I'm just going to reactivate this since it made no difference whatsoever. I need to be able to get to this last one here, and I honestly don't know how to do that. This is not cool? Or is there going to be like a... strange. Let me see if we can move this slot and go check what's up with that. I feel like I'm gonna need more potions of levitation here. I hope I have enough potions of levitation. Just for this one section here. I don't think that elevator is coming down anymore. Let us go check if this is the one that has locked things up for us. I wish we could levitate up faster, but I guess this is all we can do for now. No, we can't. I tried like using the run key to see if we could levitate faster, but no. No, that's not it either. I'll just take the fall damage. I shouldn't be as severe right now yet. So we can go ahead and enable that one. I want to try climbing this up this place here. Okay, I'm climbing up. And I'm going to try to jump down over into this section here. And I did not succeed at that. Let's use another potion of levitation then. Unless I'm out of it. No, we do have a few left. Let us quickly re-enable this and check out other ones. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and check out this one. Well, I may have been doing that, but let's just use the elevator, it's faster, I feel like. Yep, it most certainly is. missile blocked off in this area. That, of course, does nothing, whatever I can tell, but this is good and confirm whether it does anything or not. I wonder where this takes us. Oh, right. Move it for now. Is it up here or there? Ah, yes, the short elevator ride. Not sure that that's useful, if you ask me. Of course, this does not open up this. Oh, it does! Okay, but how do we get into the other places that we need to go then? Oh, wait, maybe it's this side now. No! I sort of messed up here. And I think this brings us back to the bottom of this pit here. With this one unreachable thing over there. I doubt there's an elevator coming down, but at least what we can do right now is go back up and access it again, the main area really. Now we need to figure out how do we disable that last bit of security gate that's present there. So this is where we came from. That one controls this gate, so there's no disabling that. I need to go in here, but I'm having difficulty figuring out which lever we need to activate or deactivate to get there. Can I rest here? Yes, I can. Which is strange because there's a lich right next to me. My stealth still has improved, probably because the lich hasn't detected me. Let me save the emergency slot here because I'm going to be taking the lead. Not a potion of water walking. Rather, the axe of slow falling and the potion of slow falling because I am tired of using potions of levitation. Still falling. Yeah, I don't want climbing mode, I want to fall. It's sort of strange that with the potion of still falling, you take a second to fall down. And the biggest problem is you can't control the character while he's falling down. Or she, in this case. They're falling down because, I don't know, that's just the fall mechanics of the Elder Scrolls. You fall but in slow motion, leaving you vulnerable to enemies. Now that we're down here though, I wanted to check if disabling this one enables any of the other ones. Let me pull this back. Like, take this back up, this elevator. Even the last time around, I wanted to like take a potion of slow falling or use the axe. of featherweight, but I essentially made a blunder and went all the way back up. Like it fell all the way down. I stepped too much across the ledge. No, that does not in fact open this up for us. But what it does indeed do is lock these doors now. This door is also locked. I guess we gotta go down and reactivate it. A bunch of activating or deactivating any of these actually gives us access to that one over there. I don't think they've ever been there yet. Let me just come back up and check, because this one seems essential, so I'm gonna keep this on. Why am I unable to jump onto it? I was just able to do that like a few moments ago. What just happened there? God damn! Bunny hopping extreme edition. It does not open this side, but does it open this side? No, it does not. This side is still blocked off. This is the lever that locks or unlocks these doors here. So we can't think too much about that. What about this one though? Where does this take us, I wonder? I think it takes us over to... Yeah, I think this is door number 2. No, it's not actually. It is the door that we used to come out this side. From inside the cage here. Now that we have that cleared, we can just use this one to access the other levers, to be honest. We don't really need to take the elevator in door number 2. However, this here elevator no longer works. I do want to access that, to be honest. If I have another potion of limitation, might as well go ahead and use it. I hope I do. Here goes nothing. I wonder if this does anything. That door is still locked, but is this room open? Oh, not really. I don't know what changes it did. Did it open up the... Oh right, I completely forgot. Final cage down at the bottom, Adrian. Thank you. just in the nick of time? Apparently not. It did not. It did not unlock this part. I wonder how we're supposed to go there. Unless... just go ahead and check something else. Oh, right. Can we like jump up? Thank you. Did not mean to jump up that hard, but okay. I'm not having trouble climbing onto this platform. I don't know why. It's just a thing that's happening. So this is essentially it. We gotta fiddle around with these levers here until we find out a specific combination that allows us to get inside and take out that lich over there. But this door is still locked. So is this door. And so is this door. Let me check something. Not a really impressive jump, but it does the trick. At least in this instance. Now this would lock up door numbers 2 and 3, but does it unlock door number 4? Yes, it does. Yes, it does. So what we need to do is head back and go down there then. I wonder if this takes us anywhere. Although I think if we wanted to go to door number 4, I think this would be the one. Unless it was for door number 5, the one that is inside. I think you can only unlock that through the use of the final. Yeah, this is door number 5, the one that is inside the cage. I think you can only unlock door number 5 through the use of the final. What do you call it? Let us head back down, and hopefully we won't die this time around. Yeah, we need to go up here. Not up there, we need to go down there actually. Alright, time to pop in another potion of slow falling. All of that here. Since I have potions, I'm not using the axe. Good thing I didn't enter climbing rope this time around. I did again, but it's okay. It's fine. I don't really mind it. I do hope that this elevator still works. Like, this path is still unbarred. We just have to get to that. I bet the way to that is through door number 4. As soon as we can regain our ability to jump onto this here platform. I hope the door is not locked. That's all I can hope for. I think it does lock the door though, so I don't really know how else to do this except for. Yes, it does lock this door up too. Hmm. that one needs to get unlocked. So how is it that we make it down there? I mean, you have this one here which has no effect on this these doors. Process of elimination yet again. There are enemies nearby, okay. I just want to check out if this does anything. If this perhaps opens up yet another door, then we can probably like go through door number 3 into door number 5. If that is at all a way for us to go. That door is still locked. But doors number 2 and 3 are now locked. So then. Time to head back down. I do have another potion of levitation, otherwise climbing up is gonna be a little rough. If not, I'll just have to load up the PVC that I need. Huh. Potions of levitation, do we have any? Oh wait, I overrode the emergency save. I think we have 2 moves, so that should be good. I wouldn't say it's good enough, but I think that should be good. We can take a shortcut from here, or we just climb all the way up here instead. But let me just go ahead and get the best here. I think the lit sauce for people with the jumping and running is improved. Okay, good. Now, what do I want to invest points in? Speed, of course. 2 points, 1 point in endurance, 1 point in strength. Now, time to rest again. After I'm fully healed, of course. Time to save this game here. Yeah? Made some progress finally. This elevator is an express ride. This takes us out somewhere we haven't been before. Oh, hi there, Boost. Do you have anything for me? Nothing. Oh. This just go, I'm just going to receive one part of this slot here before I touch this. Yeah, nothing. Let us hope that opens up the last beginning door so that we can actually go ahead and do what we came here to do. This is a long dungeon gate. I don't know how long this is there. I think 2 hours already, or maybe 1.5 hours. It's also it does not open this door up, but I wonder if it has opened up the other door there. Did it open up that door? Of course not. I guess it must have opened up that door at the very bottom of this, yeah. That cage at the very bottom of this level. Should we? Yeah, might as well. Push, I'm still falling. And after all of this, we also have to go ahead and take care of the Lich, so we're still that. I do see that quite a few potions are still falling, so I think, like levitation, so I think we're good on that. No problems regarding that thus far, I suppose. See a warrior here of sorts. A very powerful warrior, rather. 255 gold pieces. Good thing I leveled up. Now I can carry gold loot. But here's the thing. So that's just where the raid was, this is where the warrior is. Let me just go ahead and mark this all up in the map and save. Let me activate this and hopefully we can get out of the final. Oh, I still still falling active. No wonder I can't climb or jump right now. At least I could climb. I'm hoping this opens up the final door. Otherwise we'll have to resort to a lot of trickery to get back up. I think not though, I think it will be quite simple to just have to them forward there. Yeah, it's still locked off. Oh no! Wait, what? Oh, right. I'm stupid. I was facing the other way around. I was supposed to go the other way. I won't open the map here because that's just gonna like pause me right here. I got confused there. I thought this was the path that we are supposed to take. I don't know how or where this warrior decided to randomly show up. But yeah. It's strange that that elevator still takes us down through the same path. Time to call it this elevator. I hope that unlocks the doors that need to be unlocked. Because if it doesn't, I'll be very sad, to be honest. I mean, it's not that big of a deal. We can just climb up like different shafts. What is this? Okay, I'm sort of doing. Oh, right, it's finally opened the cage. Let me rest up. I'm healed, my jumping skills are good. Now let me go ahead and save the emergency slot here. This should be where it is. And before I square up against this Lich, I just want to an hourglass bottle and a chalice. A silver one at that. The Liches in this game can be deadly, from what I know. So that's a lich right there. So let me pop in a potion of Resist Fire and a potion of Resist Frost and a potion of Resist Shock. Now we can go and fight this guy. Ah, and who would have thought that I would have required a potion of free action that early on? I'm sort of nervous right now, I'm not gonna lie. Good thing I went out and bought like quite a few potions of free action. Oh, that was easy. I was expecting it to be more difficult, but it was not that as difficult. And I suppose that's the list that we were looking for. 1430 gold pieces, my god. Right then. Oh, we already have a soul, look at that. He's demarcated in the corner there. The top left corner of our... Let me just rest here until I'm fully lethal. And override the... Where did the... Ah, here it is. And let me just go ahead and save and see when we load this slot since we successfully completed this. Time to get out of here then. Finally, the successful quest. And it was long, and this, I suppose, was quite hard, and fuzzy so myself. Like, an intense puzzle section there, the kind that I never imagined I would have to solve. Now, how do we get back up? First off, let me just zoom back out and see where it is exactly that we have to go. So, we have to go there. This is the path we have to take. So, how do we get there is the question. Alright. We head down here and then we go down here. And then we head further down and further down. So essentially we just take the path on the right and keep following it up. That's literally it. It was so close to the entrance too. My god. I would never have imagined actually. No, which way? We take a right and we keep following it up, and ultimately we will reach this here section wherein we can take the elevator down. Straight. Right, this is where we came in, and soothing music again, which is always a welcome to my ears in single time that I hear it. I want to save here because I don't know what's going to happen as soon as I get down there. I'm hoping that the enemies, or rather the denizens of the Castle of Sentinel, aren't hostile to me, but I have no idea if they're going to be or not, so I'm just going to keep my sword drawn and walk at a nice pace. They did not seem to be hostile to me at all. Alright, time to cheat this. Like, exploring Castle Sentinel in itself is quite maze-like. And the dungeon there, whew. Maze-like in its own right. Hi there, thank you for letting me tour your castle. Are you a Cyclops? No, you're just... Your facial features aren't that well-defined. That's it. Prince... Loton. It is nice to meet you. A bow in your honor. The only person in all of Sentinel that I actually like. What time is it right now? Almost evening, like it is literally evening. Let me just go ahead and put some of my stuff that I picked up along the journey into the wagon. I'll also need to purchase some more arrows for myself. We have a few things that we need to identify, so that's that. And I think we're good with everything else. Now then, let us hop onto a horse on top of the, you know, on top of Castle Sentinel and make it to Dragon Tail Mountains. Scourg Barrow. Yes, I do. Yes, I do. Ship. Put horse though across ship. Fallen headstone. I stumble over a fallen headstone and my critical strike has improved. Alright then, time to drink this back out. And enter the damn dungeon. I'd make a save here because, well, I know the layout more or less right now. Okay, I've been bunny hopping way too much in this game today. And I don't know why that is. Again? Seriously? Okay, from this side maybe? Good. Took a little bit of damage there, but it's okay. I don't really mind that. As long as I don't have to fight these zombies, they seem unaware of me, so let us keep it that way. Bats. It's like every single time I come here, I have to fight my way through all these things just to go ahead and seek an audience with the King of Worms. And his door is always locked on top of that. Ooh, so. Turns out that my shirt of undeniable access spell, it was still active. Alright, let's talk to you then. King of Worms. Oh, holy King of Worms. Or rather, unholy King of Worms. Well done, Grimfangs. I'm sure the prince will be most cooperative. Please accept this edoric as a token of my appreciation. And in addition, I've decided that it is time for someone outside of Tiber Septim's line to know the truth about the Underking. As you know, Tiber Septim was the first emperor of Tamriel. Toward the end of his wars of conquest, he betrayed his battle mage, Zurin Arctus. When Zurin died, his soul refused to leave his body, something to do with the mysterious new medium. Since that time, Zurin Arctus has lived on as the Underking. So the Underking is apparently the battle mage of Tiber Septim, I see. The Underking and his agents have been a thorn in my side for centuries. Just remember, should the Underking regain his mortal body, he would surely throw all of Tamriel into conflict. I'm not sure what it is that you're trying to do here, but just an etheric unknown powers. I'll have to get that identified too. Hi there. Always like bumping to you guys. Alright, so back out again. And time to head out of this accursed place that this guy likes to call home. Always gives me the creeps coming here. Yeah, I'm not sticking around to talk to you guys. Sorry. This okay? I think so. Can we climb, please? Finally. Okay. Maybe. Okay, this side. I think I made the same mistake the first time around that I was playing this game as well. The way I hear these sounds, it honestly sounds like somebody's squeaking right into my ears. And it just drives me crazy, to be honest. Broken pot shirts. It always takes so much time every time I enter an exit Scourg Barrow. I mean, look, it's already 12 hours. I wonder if time travel is different down there. Anyway, let me just get on my horse and go somewhere that is a little more hospitable to me. That would be quite good. I'm gonna be going there for some potions anyway. So yes, I do wish to travel to Korea. 15 days by ship. Alright. It's free for me anyway. Like, all the travel is free for me anyway. Today is 16th of Midir, the traditional day for the Midir celebration, perhaps to alleviate the annual news of the Emperor's latest tax increase. The town temples offer blessings for only half the donation they usually suggest. I mean, blessings for me as well. So actually, healings are free, not blessings. Many so blessed feel confident enough to enter the high rock dungeons when they are not fully prepared. So this joyous festival has often been known to turn suddenly into a day of defeat and tragedy. I don't think I see anybody after my life right now. So with that being said, thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, thank you for sticking around until the end. It was a long, long dungeon crawl, longer than I would have liked it to be, but in the end, I come out feeling a sense of purpose and achievement with all of it. And yeah, I would like to say it is quite nice. It's a very nice feeling. But the next time we come back, we'll be covering we'll be doing new quests for the Knights of the Ruse. Since we are already a marshal, I think the next upgrade would be, I don't know what the next upgrade is actually, but yeah, we will be targeting the next upgrade, which would be one step from Paladin, I suppose. So at any rate, I will see you guys then. Until then, take care. Fear thee well, fellow things.